because we were medically qualified, they gave us some kind of officer rank. And we went for basic training and learning how to march and shoot and all that. And then you had to talk to them about where you might spend your 2 years. And I was terrified. I'd never been in an aeroplane. I didn't want to go in one of those. And I didn't want to be shot either particularly. So I volunteered to stay in the UK. And 2 weeks later, I found myself in the docks boarding a ship for Singapore. They were short of what they called medical specialists. And because I had the membership, yeah. I was a medical specialist. So off I went to Singapore on this troop ship. That was a cock-up. They normally flew people to Singapore, but they put me on a military ship by chance. A very interesting ship, actually, because the British had taken this from the Germans at the end of the war. It was called the Empire Fowey. And it had been one of Hitler's pleasure ships. You know, he had this system for taking the young, beautiful male and female Aryans out to sea and let them breed. So the Fowey had quite an interesting history, but even a more interesting steering mechanism, because they couldn't steer it in a straight line. And this is, I had this confirmed quite recently by an old ship's captain I met who'd actually sailed it. So you had to go to the left and then correct and go to the right. So you zigzagged. And the British Army had never used it before we went to the Far East, and they didn't realize that the Suez Canal was slightly narrow. So we ran aground. And it was, of course, just after the Suez War, and we were surrounded with jeering Arabs for days. Anyway, we got to Singapore, and I guess because I had no pediatric experience, they decided to put me in charge of the pediatric ward in the big military hospital in Singapore. I went, did a locum up in North Malaya for a couple of weeks, and that was the only bit of war I saw, because the Chinese terrorists tried to derail that train, shoved a log over the line. That was a bit of excitement, but we survived all that. But because looking after the children in that, you had children from all parts. You had the military, the children of the British military, but we had the Gurkhas and Malays, and then of course a lot of the Commonwealth kids. And one of the first children I had to look after was a little Gurkha child called Jasbir Tapper, whose father was a sergeant in the Gurkhas. And she'd come down to with her father, and she'd been down for about 2 or 3 years, and she was just profoundly anemic. And she just lived on blood transfusions, and there was no diagnosis. And it was, in fact, getting very difficult to transfuse her because there'd be no real pediatric experts, so her veins, as you can imagine, were in an awful mess.